Shh, winners talking.
So let's be real, yeah? Like, out of all the teams, like, I've seen Liverpool slap up teams. Like, really and truly, until that third goal went in, I know, I even see it in one of the groups, man, them, as soon as that third goal went, it's like, they, you know, like, man can take a deep breath and relax.
Who?
Like, from, because they know.
Who are you talking about?
Like, fans, like, that certain Liverpool fans that I interact with. That's maybe them. Not yourself.
No, not me,
But maybe not yourself, but Liverpool, it's like, you know what? We got the third goal.
Because, that's to secure,
because
the victory.
Game went on, you kind of know that Arsenal
To secure the victory. But listen, when we're playing Arsenal in the league, I never doubt victory.
Yeah, come on. I kind of feel like...
I never doubt victory.
But it's only now, with my team, I've actually got some confidence behind them.
Say we played you lot in the league last six times. How many of you lot won? None, Ale. Let's be real.
We beat you last season.
Oh, yeah. After we won the cup, right? Yeah. But in the last six times, other than that, you've won one, right?
Yeah,
you won one. So that's what I'm trying to say. In the league, it's a different kind of gravy. In the last six, I said no. I said the last six.
Can certain man chuck up the statics and the data, please?
We need some stats. We need some data.
Last three seasons. I've got to draw from my phone. We need some data.
Hey, anyone can check behind the scenes. Last three seasons. So that's six matches. You beat us once, and that was after we won the league. And we down two.
At least statistics.
So let's leave that. That's facts.
At least statistics.
Now that I've addressed that, because that's where I was trying to go.
Yeah.
The Villa thing. What I'm saying to you is. The man them got too arrogant. The man them got too cocky. They disrespected the game and they got punished.
Happened to the best team in the world.
Thank you. Now listen. Mm-hmm. I'm very glad that my cousin keeps singing it. Does that happen to the best team in the world? Let me break this down for you, right? When you don't respect your opponent, that's what can happen. Anthony Joshua got punched up by Andy Ruiz. He's your number one guy, Allah. He got punched. Then he didn't respect the war game. He got come back, refreshed himself. Is Ruiz a better fighter than Joshua, Daps? Oh, I didn't think so. Next time he got tumped up all over the place, but he didn't respect the game.
The way that you lost was.
Anthony Joshua got slacked out like it was 7-2. I like.
7-2.
But Anthony Joshua's a by far superior boxer.
But
by far superior boxer than Andy Ruiz.
7-2 is mad.
And so
it's
was the. But listen,
mad.
I'm not
it's
saying
mad.
It's not mad, my brother. Yeah, I'm saying mad. That when
glad,
Joshua.
I'm glad we've established
I know,
that.
I know it's mad, but this is my thing to me. It could have been. Listen, it could have been 26-2. You're still only going to get 3 points.
You came prepared for
You're only going to get 3 points. No, but you're only going to get 3 points.
You came prepared.
You're only going to get 3 points. Tell me, did they get extra points because it was seven?
No, but they still took points.
Did Man City lose 5-1 the week before?
Wenger still got the gold cup, so that's all that matters. He's still got the gold cup.
Did Man City lose 5-1 the week before?
Yeah, but man.
Right, hold on. It's only teams that are winning in that league to me is Man City or Liverpool. I'm not interested in anyone else. To me, why I'm not concerned is because it's a game of who's going to lose the most out of Man City and Liverpool right
all
now.
All I'll say...
And Man City have already lost, we've lost.
But your next game against Everton is a big
game. I'm saying this. We could lose that. But I'm still saying we're going to win the league. We could lose that. We could lose that.
Don't give me joke. Bub,
we could lose that. But listen...
We could lose that.
But listen, I'm not saying we're going to lose though,
up,
you know. I'm saying we're going to win. Because what you are also not looking at is we didn't have Hendo, Mane, and Alisson.
That's
a big thing. So them man that will rise up the machine when he's getting techie is them man there.
But does it mean when you look at that Liverpool team, if certain man ain't in the squad, it's
not
a dead
really
side,
because
average side.
Listen to what I'm saying. Hold on, calm down.
No Henderson.
Good call. Good call. Hold on.
Listen.
Let me show you something. When Henderson, you're forgetting Alisson was out for the first 3 months last season.
Yeah, but other
man was out last season. Listen,
them,
it is
them,
what it is.
With them three man missing,
I hear you.
You're an average side.
We're not average side. You men are average side with all your players in it.
No.
Just know that.
No, with all your players.
You made some signings now.
Listen. You know this though.
Let me tell you this.
You know Arsenal. You've seen the come up. You've seen
like
the rise
this.
Up.
We're going to keep doing this because you know why I'm laughing about you?
I just want you to just be honest.
You lot are celebrating the next team's victory like it was you. You played us the week before. Why didn't you do that?
No, but we're celebrating.
No, why didn't you do that?
No, we're still celebrating the FA Cup.
I want to know. You're celebrating the next man's victory.
I'm still celebrating the FA Cup.
Yeah, because. Let me show you.
I know how Liverpool man were moving when we was in our banter.
I'm here for it. All Liverpool man, I'm here for you, lot. Let me show you.
When we was in our banter season,
I like this.
When we was in our banter season, man had a lot to say.
When was the banter season?
Last season was meant to be our banter.
You man have had a couple banter seasons. Listen to what I'm saying.
Last season was meant to be the banter one.
Do you know what it is with Arsenal too much? Do you know what it is with Arsenal that I can't take?
FA Cup.
You lot celebrate mediocrity too much.
No way.
Why man celebrate FA Cup? Why man? Listen, I haven't even mentioned.
Best
I haven't even
world.
Mentioned.
That's the best cup in the UK.
Hold on.
You can win.
I haven't mentioned that my team are the World Club champions.
Bro,
that,
listen,
in the last three,
no disrespect.
Hold on.
I respect it.
Hold on. Do you know why you're not?
Man, have to respect what we. have to respect what we're doing.
All right.
Like,
now listen,
for
the FA Cup,
era, man, the FA Cup,
you got to be in it to win it. You lot won it. I salute that. But I can't let you lot talk too much grease.
Beat the best team in the world, which they self-proclaimed best team in the world to take the Community Shield. And you had a start in lineup. That
penalties,
strong,
penalties.
But it's still
with
a win.
The with the B team.
I take
but
it.
But you got to take
you
it.
You got to take the wins.
But those games
take
there.
All wins.
Listen,
I take little wins and
I
celebrate little
listen,
wins and big wins.
Those games there.
A win is a win. I
listen,
celebrate
listen,
little
wins. Listen,
I hope
those
people
games
listen.
There,
these are life lessons we're teaching
people.
No.
Listen. Those games there. Those games there. I salute. But I did say on both of them games. Ask my brother. I said, we'll lose the FA Cup because he's going to play, because them men ain't playing serious, and we'll lose the Community Shield because them men ain't playing serious. And this stems to the problem I'm saying. I'm not overly bigging up the team. I'm saying they're arrogant. They don't raise their game for certain games.
No, they.
You understand what I'm saying?
They raise their game. They raise,
oh my
man.
God. What, listen, for what? That Community
listen,
Shield?
Bruv, they lost one game last season.
Yeah, that's the league.
No,
that's what I'm talking about.
Tell a lie,
I'm talking...
Tell a lie. They lost to Watford.
Yeah,
they lost to Watford and we brought them up.
But
in the
you're not
well,
listening
so
to me.
I'm pretty sure.
And so did Man City. But what I'm saying, what I'm saying to you is, they don't raise their game for certain games. When they lost to you lot in the league and whatever, remember, they lost, already won the league. They down tools after they won the league. They stopped playing. They weren't playing the same. It was obvious.
There was things to play for, though. But
like what? Like winning what? But anyway, just to wrap it up on the head, my team are still
the best team in the world.
And
he
got
said
slapped.
It. He said it.
And they got slapped and held, and they held
but
a 7-2.
Listen, but what I'm saying
on
is,
on that note, I'm a pork, I'm Henny.
You man play, or unless anyone, you Gunners, to the Gunners that are getting too happy, you man played us and didn't do it. So don't celebrate a next man's victory like that. That's not masculine. You're celebrating next man's victory.
Oh, no, real masculine.
You're celebrating
shit
the next
here.
Man's victory.
Listen.
You didn't win. You
listen.
Didn't win it. So on that note,
we
note, move.
We move.
Let's go.
Man, pour up.
Pour up. We're ready. Get the Eddie ready. So that's for the football section.
Yeah, so where are we going today with this one? I'm looking forward to hearing what the topic of the day is.
Right, as we move on now, topic of the day business. I've got to give you a backstory to it.
All right.
So how we come to the topic.
Yeah.
So I've gone to butt my brethren yesterday at the gym. He's there. When I get there, he's thumping up a bag or whatever. He's a man like me and you, Douglas. Usually good vibes, happy, running joke, all the time. Always on energy. You know one of them man there?
Yeah.
But when I've got there, I can see his mood's off. He's kind of quiet.
Yeah.
I'm chatting to him, he ain't really saying nothing. He's kind of within himself. So I'm like, what's up, lad? He's like, nothing. Just keeps working on the back. I'm like, okay. Leave him. We finish up training, do our thing. I'm like, go on, you want to go for a food? Go for the food, sitting down. Went across to Hernando's across the road. The man ain't really eating his food. Kind of pushing it around his plate. I'm hungry. I'm boxing off my food. You know them ones?
Yeah. So Saturn's going on. Yeah.
So I've just gone to him now. Blood, come on. What's the deal now? What's going on, blood?
Talk to me.
Man looks at me and goes, fam, women in this generation, they're differently trash.
Wee.
Like that.
Yeah. Like, so he was in his feelings.
He said, women, straight, look at my face. Women from the heart, blood. He said, women in this generation are differently trash. Differently trash. You didn't just say
differently trash.
So I was like, rah. Wow. I just thought to myself,
let's go.
Before I explain how he broke down to me of what's gone on, that's going to be the topic of the day, bro.
Well, okay, this generation of women, are they differently trash?
Differently trash, blood.
And this is a big topic.
That's what I'm trying to say.
This is a big
That's
damn
what I'm
topic.
Trying to say.
We can really expand on this shit today.
So let's let me start by telling you what he said happened in his situation. Because let's be clear, he said to me, I said, boy, well, I might talk this on the pod. He goes, yeah, man, bring it to the congregation.
He wants
opinion.
Let me hear what them man say.
You know what
yeah,
I'm saying?
Yeah,
so I said, yeah, I'll take that to Sunday service.
Yeah.
So basically what he's saying is gone on is like.
So this is his testimony.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Sunday service.
Sunday service.
So
come
yeah,
on.
He said that basically, he's with a girl, yeah?
Yeah.
Woman, however you want to break it down. And he's gone there, I don't know, Friday, whatever it is, to drop a little monies because it's her daughter's birthday. So he's gone to drop a little change. When he's dropping the change, she's come out and she's like, yeah, She's dressed up a little piece. She's like, yeah, I'm going out. Very. Man, they were laughing already. Easy. It's not, I don't know, anyway. He's gone, yeah. So See, how the man them know. Man them have, see, I know man them will know these. See, I can see where the opinions guys are ready. Give it a chance. Give it a chance. I even said nothing yet. The man said
I'm waiting to hear this one.
The man said was unbiased.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So man them, let's pattern up.
I'm trying to hear this one.
Let's hear this. So where was I? Yeah, so he's gone to drop the money for the daughter or whatever. And then she's come out. She's going out. Little chat with her, rare. Have a good time. Tell her to go enjoy yourself. Have a good time. He's a true guy. He's like us, proper man. He ain't on no, oh, don't go out. Don't do wear that. Go do your thing, babes. Enjoy yourself. You know, like that. So, don't know, whatever. He's like, yeah, she's gone. Two-twos. He's gone about his business. Got back to his yard. I don't know. I think he went out as well. He's like, he's in now. She's messaged him or called him, whatever. She's messaged, that's it. He's rang her. She said, ring me. He's rang her. Say 1 o'clock or something like that. Do you have a good night? Blah, 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 blah. She's like, yeah, it was good. Rah, 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 rah. Went with my girls. We had fun. Da, 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 da. He says he ends up chatting. They're chatting on the phone till like a 3 a.m. Okay, you know, chatting, niceness.
So this is the same thing that was going out.
The same thing was going out. She's coming. She's kept chatting. No. So the man them are kind of, so it ain't gone the way that man might have thought it was going to go.
Yeah.
So I'm hearing this. I'm like, okay. Now, bear in mind, his thing with this girl is he's breaking it down to me is that, cause I've met her, she's nice. She's, I ain't, that's why I can't say too much in it. I want you, man, to kind of, you know?
Yeah.
So his thing is that they're mad close. Chat on a daily, vibes, joke, honesty. She could say to him like, well, this man, I mean, and he'll laugh and vice versa. They open up. He's that guy, he likes that. So anyway, they spoke to her like 3 a.m, whatever. Conversation done, lock off. He said he's gone then, whether it was the next day, a couple of days later or something, eat her food. Him and his reasoning and running joke and rare. Now, there's some acquaintance, I think he said, like, there's an acquaintance, like, a man that from the estate that he grew up on, by chance, is a parent at her kid's school.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like that?
Yeah. Mm. I see where this one's going.
Let me go. I'm trying to recite it like I kicked it to me. I want to make sure I don't mess nothing up.
Yeah.
I don't want to miss nothing up.
Yeah.
So he's like, yeah, they've got, just by chance, the brother's daughter goes her kid's school and it's a guy from his estate that when he was younger, that he's, you know, they're cool. Everybody knows each other and all them kind of thing there. So with that said, he said to her now later on that day, rah, he's kind of just scrolling through his phone on the gram and he's seen, oh yeah, that's it. The brother, who it is, through after quarantine, he's been throwing some like lockdown, after like post-lockdown kind of event.
He
gets like a big gazebo and all of that, and he's been having like cocktail things going on. He's got a big yard. So he's having a gazebo thing.
Yeah.
People come throwing parties here and there. So my man's like, yeah, he's like, Pete, I was there now, and like I'm scrolling through Donnie's gram, and like.
Do you reckon he touched a little bit of insecurity and thought is he just being nosy? Or
what's
what,
that?
What made him want to scroll through the gram? Like, what was he?
No, he's scrolling through the gram and it's come up in his newsfeed.
Oh, okay, yeah.
He's gone.
Yeah.
He didn't know. It's not a searching thing.
Okay, so it's a coincidence.
Yeah, pure coincidence.
Yeah.
So he's saying he's sitting on the gram and he's just said to her, like, oh, rah, my man, I don't know, say his name's Marvin.
Mm.
Marvin had another one of his things the other day. Kept it moving. She's gone, oh, yeah, that's where I went.
Mm-hmm.
He's like, oh, is it? Yeah, that's where me and the girls went. And yeah, he was there still. We were speaking a little piece and he's a joker and, you know, he makes me laugh. And he's like, oh, see? All right, is it? He said he kept it moving.
Yeah.
But he goes, pee. He goes, when I went my yard and I went my bed, about 1 o'clock, I woke up. Like, hold on.
Hold on.
I kept a straight face. Because I was like, okay. He goes, I thought to myself, but hold on a minute. You've rang me when you've got in at 1. We spoke for 3 hours.
Yeah.
And at no point have you said to me that you're with a Donnie that I know personally at his party.
Yeah.
And you know, and it's like, she knows that he knows homeboy. Yeah, like, she knows they're well acquainted, well affiliated. Like, you've not mentioned to me that you was at his thing. You've not mentioned to me that you and him was all talking. until I've said something. And it's weird. He's like, it's weird to me because we were speaking for all of 2 hours.
Yeah.
So he's going, P, what do you think? I was like, boy, listen, I don't know, keep talking. He said to me, yeah. I rang her. So whatever time he woke up in the morning. He goes, he rang her in the morning. She woke her up and she's gone. And like stuck in like, it's weird to me like how that's gone on. And she's gone, yeah, I just didn't think to say nothing very at the time. He goes, but we was talking, like you never mentioned it. It's the guy I know. Yeah, and she's gone, yeah, well, you know, yeah, he texts me as well. And you know, I text him back and so he's like, hold on, but wait.
And what this is his missus? That's his gal, he says it's serious.
Like, he goes,
he drops money to the king.
Oh, yeah.
From a man's dropping money to the kid.
Let's recap. Yeah, he's dropping money to the youth.
Put some respect on the man's name, man. Put some respect on his name.
Dropping money for your youths,
Yeah. Right, say that. So where was I? So he said that, yeah, she said, oh, yeah, text, and he texts back. So he's like, hold on a minute, what? So he goes, so you're telling me, we spoke at when you've got back. Donnie's, you've been with my brethren. Left, got my brethren's party. Left there. Been with him at the party. Left there. Come back and you're texting each other.
So exchange numbers.
That's what killed it. He said, why are you on the phone to me? Yeah. And she never mentioned nothing.
Wow.
While she was on the message, while she's on the phone to him.
Yeah, they're chatting.
A text has come in from homeboy. She like he said that it's something just like the nah. But check the joke. Hear the joke on top of that. She's saying she just texted to say like, oh, thanks. It was a for the invite me. It was a nice time.
Invite him
or whatever it was. Yeah, I don't want to misquote. I'm trying not to misquote meeting, but basically, thanks for nice because he's the host, isn't it? Thanks for nice. He's text back whatever he's saying and yeah, can I say you're looking sexy? Oh, God. Man said, oh God. Why she's on the phone to homeboy and she ain't mentioning it.
Does homeboy know that then to check?
He's saying it's not Marvin's fault. He said he ain't interested in Marvin.
Yeah, yeah.
He said Marvin don't know. Marvin don't know.
Because man them are going to shoot their shot.
Man them are going to do what they do.
Come on.
Man them are going to do what they do.
Yeah.
But what he's saying is, he's saying to her, you as meant to be my ace.
Yeah. Got to conduct yourself in a certain way.
How could you be on the phone to me?
Yeah.
You've come from my brethren's thing. You spoke with my brethren. You're on the phone. My brethren's messaging you back and forth. And you ain't, and you're not telling me. You're obviously not telling me for a reason. Bearing in mind, he's saying to me, and I know he's true. She could tell him anything. He's true like that.
They run
joke and be like, yeah, this one try and move to me. Because man will try and move to, we know what it is. It's life. He's a G like that.
And then if you're saying he's like, man, then he's laid back. It's like, ah, okay, like whatever, innit?
Exactly.
Yeah.
So obviously, I shouldn't say it too much because I know her. I'm saying for her to not tell him this one, there's obviously something behind it. Yeah, especially them time and that. While you're on the phone to man.
Yeah.
But he said to bring it to the congregation.
You're slightly feeling, man.
He said to bring, she's slightly feeling, man, and that. Obviously, she's feeling him. She's feeling the dude.
Yeah.
So my thing was, I said, let me bring it to the congregation. I said, I'll ask them. He said, nah. I said, is it cool? He said, cool. Do it. Let the man them speak. So go ahead. Man them say their piece. Yeah. Tell me what you think on that, Douglas.
Yeah,
you better pass me a champagne on that, alive,
lad. That's why I tell you. You know what? You did well getting that.
I had to get it all out. Let's keep it moving.
Let's keep it moving, fam. Now,
shout out to my homeboy.
Like, so now, in a way, from that little madness there, it's just giving him the impression that Gala trash. Car.
That's why he's saying.
I get it because at the same time, like, if this is your girl. And like, man, I'm moving around, and she's texting man while you're on the phone to her, and doing all of that. That's some real trashy behavior, like real talk. Because that's like you're holding secrets, so therefore you're up to something.
Do you know what the man said to me as well? Sorry to cut you, Doug. He said exactly that. He said, "How I break it with these girl, she's my ace. Me and her should have the secret on people. There should be no man that has a secret on me."
Yeah. Straight.
She's not lying.
G shit.
Yeah.
Masculine shit,
bro. That's some real shit.
Learning.
Peak game. And you know where from real shit. From this real niggas.
This is it. And this is what I'm saying. I felt his pain. Right now, there's no secret. Like, anything that happens, you have to let it go. Like in a sense that, like, you see, like if something go on and you have to just be like, this is what happened.
Mm.
Because when you lie and you hold secrets, that's already the distrust and the break of codes and that. You get me? Where we've been there in the past. Like, you get what I'm saying? So now it's a case of, right, this is what it is.
I rate him for that. He came straight out and told me because you know what it is at the end of the day? He's just saying like, raw, especially from the environments that we come from, loyalty and trust is everything.
Yeah.
You've got to be able to trust. who you're laying with,
confiding in.
And he said he's mad open with her. He said, tells her everything. Who you're laying with is sacred. So for her, it's, she's, because he said that she's on the tip of, but not, I haven't done anything. And I'm saying to him, bro, I fully understand, but understand where you're coming from. But I said, I'll let the man, I'll let Big Doug speak on
You know,
continue
what?
On, Douglas. Bro,
listen, it's one of them ones where he's not wrong. Like, at the end of the day, he's real for feeling what he's feeling. Do you get what I'm saying? And this is scenarios man's heard before. Do you get what
man
I'm saying? Where people
food.
Feel like they feel disrespected or something due to something in the relationship happening where there's a lack of trust or whatever. So man understands it. Do you get what I'm saying?
Fully.
But then the girl now, like, differently, like, needs to pattern up and be real and tell man what it is. Do you get what I'm saying? And be on some level where, even if it happens, say it. Yeah, man's going to be upset and he's going to be vexed for it, but you have to let it go.
The joke is, that's exactly what he said to me as well. He goes, she can tell me anything in the world if she was honest.
Yeah.
He goes, he's like that. Like, all he wants is, he said, it's the snaking and the sneaking that's hurting him. I watched my man couldn't eat.
Yeah.
I said, rah. A man's hench. He's tick, always eating.
Yeah.
Tick, nod. He was pushing the food around the plate. Man ain't eating. He's like, boy, I ain't eating since I'm vexed.
Yeah.
And you know, because the girl, what can he do? There's nothing he can do. He's not going to go and put it on the guys. Men do what men do, innit?
Yeah, straight.
Men do what men do. But yeah. I can feel for him. But I said I'd bring it to the congregation. And that's why the topic today is, what has he said again? Women from this generation are differently. Don't miss out the differently, you know? differently trash. I got to quote him because I said to him, I'm bringing it for him. So we've got to bring the pain for him still.
Yeah, because you know what? I feel like this generation as well, where the Instagram and the social media thing, everyone can slide in DMs and do whatever, it's mad. I love, brother.
Come on.
It's mad, because, and I feel like even with the women, they got, like, I know for every woman that you chat to or every girl that's out there, they got at least 10 men in their DMs. 20. Ridiculously. They won't be honest about it because at the end of the day, it looks fucking messed up if you're saying, right, I've got 20 men in my DMs. Like, but let's be real.
It's the truth in the booth coming today.
This is where now we have to be honest about these situations.
Come on.
Like, if I've got, like, if someone says to me, oh, what, you chat to girl, I'll be like, well, yeah, of course. Like, girls message me. Or whatever, do you get me?
Keep it straight 100.
You know where it is. Because as soon as you start moving, like, raw, man ain't got no girls and all of this, and it's only you I'm talking to, and you start moving on that wave,
then all of a sudden,
when the replies start coming slow and all of that, then she's vexed at man, all of that. Do you get what I'm saying?
Keep it straight 100 all the way.
You have to keep it straight 100 all the way. And your guy now has to be in that situation where he has to look at it like, me personally, like just talking from my own personal experience, if a woman did that to me, like as soon as I feel like I have to distrust you or think you're
trying to someone else. That's the issue, the trust now.
Yeah. Like some people, like, some women, they might be in situations where they forgive their man for doing certain things. Like we're not all perfect. I've been in situations where, you know what? Man's been, you know what I mean? Forgiven for certain things. You get what I'm saying? But I feel like me on the flip side of it now, like, I can't forgive.
Burning the bridge straight away, yeah?
Huh?
Burning the bridge straight away.
Like, yeah.
For how close they are, innit? And
I know what I'm like. So if I feel like I can't trust you,
that's the thing. I know what I'm like
as well.
Yeah,
if I feel like I can't trust you, then it's not gonna work, and I can easily just call it a day and move on with my mind and keep my peace and crack on. Do you get what I'm saying? Because like not like some people like people might think that's fucked up because you know what, guys do this, guys cheat, girls forgive. If that's what they choose to do and they choose to forgive, but me, like in my heart, I know that reality, I can't do it. So like my man, he just most really has to kind of.
That's why he's so traumatized. Because let me show you something. On a level, the man's a terrorist on road. The man's a bull in a pen, dog. He's a serious guy. You know, like that.
So this happens.
This happens, so in his mind, he's like, this little, you've gone to this little idiot's thing. You've dissed me. There's nothing I can do about it. And he's saying to me like, what he's done with her, like people don't see that side of him. You know, like that. He's like, I've gone to her yard to drop something for her ute.
Yeah.
And she's left me to go and drink cocktails with my brethren.
He's looking at it deep. His mind processed the information mad deep. He's processed that mad deep.
No, it's not his kid. It's not his kid.
But he's just a real man. He's feeling so violated that the way that he's even relaying the process of the how his mind is processing it, he's just getting deep with it.
But is he totally lying though?
He's not lying. But he's processing it deep. Because he's looking at it like, rah, man's here with your ute chilling, dropped off peas, and you're drinking cocktails with my brethren. This time she was with her friend doing up her thing, but he's like,
that's what she's sticking to. She's saying, I was just with my friend. I just went, but the violation, I said, I hear where you're coming from. Because you see the not telling man and the on the phone and return two message. Because she's saying it was just a 1-2 messages back just to say thanks. But I was like, so what exactly happened? He said, the Donnie's messaged and said, I said, where the violation is? He said, the Donnie's messaged and said, like, as well, like, you was looking sexy.
But did Donnie know that she was with him?
No. But he's not saying Donnie's violating.
I know he's not saying Donnie's violating.
No, he definitely don't. But he don't know.
So their thing's just on a secret thing. They're doing their thing, undercover.
Their thing's just their thing. He don't know.
So hold on. What did he want her to say to the brother when she said that?
Nothing. He wanted her to tell him.
The interaction shouldn't be there.
Yeah, but he's keeping it secret, right?
No, he wanted her to tell him. That's all he wanted. He wanted her just to say, oh, your brethren just messaged. Your friends just messaged me.
Oh, okay, and that should be.
That's it. He said if anything else. He said if she could have told him. That's true. She said that's all it is.
Yeah, that's what you want.
That's all it is. Simple.
A friend had this piece. The piece used to have enough of the brethren in the DMs because my girl is, you know what I mean. She's out there. She's big.
Yeah.
Boy, my brethren said, boy, the only thing you got to tell me is this. Boy, if one of my people hit me up, show me.
That's it.
And bear the brother's people was hitting up. She told him. He said, boy, I'm just gonna keep it raw. It's nothing. I don't even respond.
But just a piece of mind, if you got a girl that's looking like, or a guy, that's like, whatever.
Any girl that looks good, man, them are hollering, bro. That's normal. And I have to tell him, I have to be honest, for him, he kicked all of that. He's a real dude. He said all of that. He said,
so what? But if that's the case, though, and she's not saying it, and she's not saying something, it's either that, one, even though you may look at him and think he's a cool dude, he might have another side to him that behind closed doors, man don't see. You get what I'm saying?
Possibly. Because maybe he's beating her or something. I don't know.
Was actually feeling the guy.
I think it's that she's feeling the guy.
You think that she's feeling the guy?
Whether feeling it... Now I'm all getting my opinion in and it's going to be hurting my boy's feelings. But I would say it's feeling the... If not feeling the guy, feeling the atmosphere of party. You know these girls on party shit? Like hype, man.
Yeah.
But I'm leaning towards feeling the guy. Yeah. Because otherwise, why not just say? Because she says about other things. Like...
Yeah.
He says anything like that, she just says normally. And he even said, if she had said at any point on the phone conversation with him, I went to your friend's thing, you know. I went to that guy's thing that he knows thing, you know. Da 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 da. Yeah, he was there, he was talking to us, and he just text me. He would have just been like, joker, and kept it moving.
Yeah.
His only issue is, you know the way, come on, masculine shit.
They'd have been like, he's an idiot.
Yeah, exactly.
What did he say?
Come on, exactly. Simple. And he could have kept it moving, but he said the violation is, she's gone out a way to keep it from him, from the beginning. Yeah, there's a reason behind that, like, from the beginning, from the going to the thing, she didn't say, like he said, when he asked her where she'd gone, she just went, I just went local, non-specific.
Yeah. But also, he has to reevaluate his situation and his relationship.
Of course he does.
Because in a way, the trust is gone, but if the relationship was that good, there must be something missing in their relationship.
There is.
Why she's even entertaining another man.
There is.
Because certain times, you know, if you're fully, like, as men, we know, like, right, if you're fully in something,
you ain't going to be doing all of that.
Once that starts opening, then your eyes start dancing.
It's a rap, more or less.
There's something you're lacking within that. Do you get what I'm saying?
And I said all that, but his thing is, at the minimum, if they're meant to be just the base of their friendship in the relationship, she should have just said, this is a situation. So no one's got secret on him. As he said, the best thing he said to me was, any secret should be me and them. You should never put someone in a position where it's you and them that's got a little secret.
Yeah.
And that's the drop.
Yeah.
Never put that. It should be our secrets.
Yeah.
Now you put it in a situation where it's potentially a secret for you and Donnie.
Yeah.
That's only come out because I just happened to be on Instagram. See what he's dealing with.
So is this when you see, like, going back to the topic and that? Are we saying that this generation, is a generation of a lot of behind the scenes madnesses? Man and woman.
I just think that in this generation...
Where people ain't talking up the thing.
I just think in this generation, a lot of these females are just trash, blood.
Yeah.
Straight talk like that.
Yeah.
Because it's not... Listen, there's great women out there. And the funny thing with me is, as I say that, yeah, I'm a real lover of women, you know. Like, I love women. Like, yeah. I've got an ideal in my mind of women and how they can be and what they are.
Yeah, yeah.
And when I see that,
so
I
don't mess up your thought or vision. Or
when
what,
I see that, I admire it. I respect it. I would look after it. I would do anything for it. You know them ones. Yeah. Like, when I see that, that's your characteristic. You're a good woman. You're loyal. You're making efforts. You're trying to do things. Yeah, you look after your you're looking after your kids. You're doing that stuff. I respect it so much. But when I see the trash, like, I don't know, babes, should I get some more fillers in my lips? All right, cool. But you ain't got no food in your fridge. A man's hungry, bitch. There's no fucking sandwich in there.
Yeah. Will you feed him, man?
Let's keep it true.
Yeah.
It's true. It's true today.
It's true.
So it's real shit.
This is masculine shit.
This is what I'm saying. So that's what it is.
He's not lying.
So I've got things like that. That to me is trash.
That's trash.
But
man, I get it, because you know what? On social media and people I encounter, I see more trash than that. Well, nah. There's a lot of women that man do encounter that are on job that I would say are good. Like, representation
of
the feminine species. You get me? You know what I mean? The female species.
But also, that's a choice of your own. You look at that. You want that.
Yeah. But there's a lot of trash out there.
But trash, there's a bag of trash.
And man them need to stop entertaining the trash as well, because we, you know, like, man them have to do better, because the way that man entertain the trash, they make him feel like it's good to be trashy.
Yeah, we're encouraging the trash.
Encouraging the trash.
We're encouraging the trash. We're liking
man
the trash.
Man them are double tapping that.
Man are double tapping the trash.
The double tapping the trash. And then also, on top of that, like, it's, they're double tapping it, but half of these girls that a man are like looking at and double tapping or wanna fuck, not, ain't the girl that they're gonna bring home. Never the girl they're gonna bring home. And I think sometimes the girls don't even realize that. That's why they bounce around being single for all 10 years.
Facts.
Man could come into a relationship, come out of a relationship, buck a girl that I knew, like, that I was chatting to, like, maybe 5 years ago, still single. Why is that? Right? Facts. Man wrapped you up, but you're looking hella sweet.
Because they're not running it right. This is why I say it's come to the trash thing. Because all they're offering, if all you're offering a man is your looks and your pum, you ain't saying much.
Nah.
Because that fades and the pum will get worn if you're getting it beaten out too often. Sorry to be vulgar. Sorry to be vulgar, but I have to kick it straight. Masculine shit.
But if you ain't got nothing to hold man in there,
there you go.
Then man will start looking for new pussy.
There you go. So with that said, them gal there, you must get your priorities in line. So when you're kicking, I want a Birkin bag and rear, let's not have one big whole heap of lime scale all around the bar.
Yeah.
Let's make sure that the yard's in order.
Yeah. But it's bad you say that, because I posted something today, on my story on Instagram, and it was basically a girl giving a man FIFA and how happy he was to receive that. But the caption was, man are easily pleased when it comes to gifts,
that's
but
problem
gal need a Birkin. Or it's like, if man ain't going out of their way to go mad ham, the woman ain't happy, or she's not respecting the vibes. You get what I'm saying? And I feel like that is also a trashy thing, because, like, why does it always have to be man have to go above and beyond to for you to be satisfied and to satisfy your man?
For them trash bitches, though.
Yeah. Good women out there that take the little simples.
Today, as we're discussing this topic, and I'm going in, you'll hear me use the word bitch in reference, because if I'm gonna call you trash, I may as well call you a bitch, because it all coincides.
It's all
you understand. So
it's all in
but
topic.
But don't ever think
it's all in topic.
Yeah, but don't ever think that I don't know how to differentiate between a trashy woman or a bitch and a good woman that deserves to be appreciated, honored, respected, and loved.
Yeah, straight.
But certain things we have to call out. Like, when I see my brethren situation, I'm not gonna go in and say that this woman is this or this woman is that. She, in my experience of her, she's cool. You know? She's cool. Things happen. I don't know the full ins and outs of the story. But there's women out there that are trash.
Yeah, bro.
And they're keeping up some trash and some nonsense. So that's just my opinion on it. You can kick it from there, Douglas. Go on. Tell me your thoughts. Because I'm going to be the bad guy in this already, because I've already been done some.
Hey, you know,
this,
I was looking for the juice when you said that. I weren't even looking.
Go watch that and bring it back.
I was looking over there with my alcoholic behavior. But yeah, fam. Nah, like, exactly what you're saying. Man can recognize real women when you see it, and man can recognize trash. Yeah, and like I know some of the women might even be in the comments now. We want to hear your opinion on what we're saying.
Please.
But also, don't get it twisted. We get at the man, but I feel like in the past few episodes, we've got at man them. So
that,
I feel like we need to talk to the women.
That was one of the reasons why I felt it's good to do this, because we've gone at the man them and tried to show them raise your game in 2-3 episodes.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Now we're touching on the females and saying, you know, where I feel there's some shit lacking.
Yeah, do better.
So please comment and
because
say what you
even
feel.
Like certain, like listen, even when it comes to trashy behavior, like not letting your man, not letting your like your baby father see his kids.
Talk
trashy
to him.
Behavior.
Trash.
Like, and then you want to come and slag him off. We're not fucking
trash.
With that. Like, and at the end of the day,
come on.
You know what I'm saying? Well, let's get deep. Let's start looking at what
obviously
these...
there's some situations where it's valid for you not to do that.
Yeah,
but
yeah,
when
yeah,
it comes
yeah.
to a matter of peas and money, I'm glad you said that. Like,
yeah.
I've got a Donnie that he's not getting to see his daughter, yeah? Because he was giving his baby mother, he was giving her £60 a week. The child's 5. He was giving £60 a week, and on top of that, any extras that she needed, he would give it. Any little extras.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But she's on the thing of, I want more, I want more, I want more. You should be giving me 130. Charge.
Yeah.
But she's got 2 next utes already. He's saying, you don't need all that
for my one. Yeah.
Yeah. She's saying, right, if you're not giving me, you're not seeing him.
Yeah, that's all wild.
That's minor in comparison to what normally happens.
Yeah, but that's trashy behavior.
Still
wanna,
trashy.
Man, still yeah, it's still trashy, but man don't want to kick it with a girl and then she just says, fuck it, you can't see the youth then.
That's the power they hold. And
yeah,
that's trashy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
because
but that's trashy though. You're, but this happens a lot. Because I know a lot of men that are trying to see their youth and can't.
You're taking away then, from
you know
your child. You're taking away from your child and the benefit of having the both parents in her or his life.
Or giving man the opportunity to be
trash.
There and be a dad.
Yeah, and that's trashy.
Yeah.
That's trash.
Like, don't get it twisted. There's man out there that are fuckery.
Of course.
But then there's a lot of man out there trying.
There's man
and then
trying,
the man that,
bro.
For the man then that are trying, girls, like, you got to start letting man see their youths and do, like, that's trashy behaviour.
That's
why I got to touch on that, because I see certain amount, there's a lot of man that buns them that they can't see their youths and can't, and these women take pride in hiding them doing this and doing all that kind of fuckery to them. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yes,
I agree. And causing the madness and that's like, nah, that's trashy behaviour. They're the ones that come under the bitch. Heading. You get what I'm saying?
I'm not the only one saying it.
Yeah, nah. I support you on that one still. But yeah, that because, nah, it can't work. And what else is there that out there that these girls need to listen?
There's many things. Younger, what you got to say? You've always got a lot to say about these girls. What have you got to say?
You hit the right points, innit?
Like, facts only. Go on.
So, boom. Why do you think certain girls choose to be trash and certain girls choose to not be trash? There must be something out there.
Shall I step in?
Why the girls
take
aren't
it. Take it.
Yeah.
Take the podium.
I feel like,
take
you know what, this society now, yeah, they promote fuckery.
Thank you.
They love it.
Like, girls will be like
Thank
hanging
you.
Off those. Look at the girl that was on the fucking, that dropped out the car on the M25.
All them
hanging out the car, dancing, twerking.
All them stupid.
Drop her out the car 100 mile an hour.
I saw it.
Yeah, you see what I'm saying?
I didn't even want to laugh.
Yeah.
I didn't even want to
laugh.
I felt sorry for her.
Yeah, yeah.
But then the same before, I'm like, what are you doing,
what
you
idiot?
Doing?
Like, this society promotes trash. Like,
trash.
At the end of the day, like, all right, cool. Like, the twerking thing, it is like, obviously, I'm older, and this twerking thing is of this new generation where it's like a dance.
Mm.
It, like, even you just, music comes on, and they start twerk.
But can I just say, hold that. Can you lot stop twerking with your utes in the background, and your utes just going to be traumatized?
Trash.
Can you stop that, please?
Trash.
That's too much trash. Doug, please continue.
Yeah. So, like, all of that twerking thing. But what these girls don't understand, yeah, and this is where they start calling man them thirsty and that, yeah? And like, oh, man them are thirsty, this, that. But man them, all we look at gal when they're twerking, we don't care how well you're doing it or how you've perfected it. All we see is gal ass shaking. Do you get what I'm saying? That's all man them see. Man them just see booty shaking.
Come on.
That's all man see. So, like, to man them, it's sexualized. Do you get what I'm saying?
That's the exact word I was going to use.
Yeah, it's sexualized. Like, so guys are looking at you like, rah, she's here twerking, shaking up her batty.
Yeah.
Right, I'm not saying she's a hoe, but it's sexualized. Got man going. Do you get me? Man's not respecting it. Do you get me?
Yeah, we don't make whole judgments. We don't. That's one thing with me. I ain't making no judgments on any things. That we don't say no one's a hoe or this, that, other, because I don't know your character like that.
Yeah.
But you're right. When they're doing their movements, it's a sexualized thing.
Yeah.
So if that's what you're putting forward, you're only going to arouse a certain response from a man. As man. So I agree with you fully on that.
Yeah. So that's the next thing. Like, got to do better, ladies, man. Like, got to do, not saying, listen, have your fun, innit? But know your surroundings, innit? If you're in a club, But then this is the thing, we can't stop it because even, just even as I said that, look at Carnival.
We look at all these things and what's going on. There's some, Carnival's been going on forever. And when we go Yard or when we go Grenada or if we go Trinidad, it's a bag of wine up thing.
But I don't know, but it's perceived differently though.
It's different, but it's perceived differently and it's not done out of that arena on a daily, on the internet to provoke a certain response. Because a lot of it's first trapping. You understand? There's only so many angles you can take a selfie of yourself.
You understand what I'm saying to you?
But we're in this Towie Kim Kardashian era. They're encouraging a lot of girls. A lot of girls don't even know how to switch on the washing machine and use it properly. You understand what I'm saying to you? They don't even know how to...
Can't cook.
Don't even know how to season chicken. Don't know how to season chicken. They're not from the Dutch pot generation.
No, of course not. Don't even know what a Dutch pot is.
Thank you.
When you said it, they thought it was weed.
Come on. They thought it was weed. They thought Dutch pot came from Holland.
What's that, Cali?
Come on. And I'm not saying that's what you have to do.
Yeah, straight.
But I'm just saying, like, there's certain things that are just getting lost along the way.
You understand?
They're getting lost along the way. Like the little girls now watching the twerking and thinking, right, let me get on my twerking from young. You understand?
Yeah.
So it's
a, we have to be mindful and responsible and understand, because the same way like how we jump on the guys about doing this and looking out for the youths and the women, they have to kind of be responsible and understand the message that they're giving out to their kids and what they're giving out to the generation or the people around them.
I feel so.
Yeah, because it's
how you do it as well. Like, if you're skinning it out on Instagram on a daily, and then you're talking about, oh, but no man's taking me serious.
But how can man take you serious? I guarantee you, out of the 100 things I might double tap, but I'm just keeping it 100. Out of the 100 things I might double tap,
I feel you.
The one that I'd want to take home to mum, you get me? Ain't the ones that I'm just freely giving the likes away to.
Trust me.
Because I'm like that. I give away likes. Come on. That's another thing. We'll get onto that. But some people take Instagram too seriously.
Way too seriously.
I don't... This is how easy it is for me to tap my screen.
Simples.
That's how easy it is. It don't mean nothing to me. I'll slide through. I see everything. Any of my brethren could be skating, putting up football. You know what I'm saying? We'll get onto that later, another day, about how people take this Instagram thing way too seriously. But I guarantee you, I could give 100 likes that way. But the one real one that means... You know what I'm saying? That I could possibly... be the one. I might not even like it.
The one real one. I'm not even liking it. I'm not even liking it.
She's probably not even on the gram. She's not even on the gram. But when you check it, we don't follow each other. I hear that. When you go on her page, she may have got all 300, like 500 followers. Less than that. You get what I'm saying? You're not even like
less,
because you're not even about that. And what girls don't even realize is like, the social thing. Everyone wants to buy bare followers and all of this. But half of the time, man, them are more... from even when I chat to brothers, man, them are like, rah, this girl... Man, them are like, rah, bruv, I found this thing. Like her. Bruv, she only got 200 followers, you know?
Like, they're happy with
that. Like, man, are happy for that, you know? You know what I'm saying? She ain't even bait. She's out here keeping her head down. So, man, I'm schooling you ladies. Like, sometimes half of this follow man and gal follow this and man follow that thing. Sometimes some real guys ain't even looking at that, and that's like bait. You get what I'm saying?
Some people called me those pick me girls though.
What's that?
The ones that are going pick me.
I've only got 200 followers. Pick me.
Yeah, boy, bro. It's swing.
You can't win.
I'm not even just saying going off of social media, because we can all look at a page. People just like when people post pictures, they give you what they want you to see. So at the end of the day, if you're really picking girls off of the back of like social media, thinking, oh well, she don't twerk, that means she's cool. Like at the end of the day, when you get to know a girl, she might not be twerking on camera for the gram, but then when you go raving with her, she might be a different type of beast. You get what I'm saying?
Like, see girls like they're strategic with their trash like behaviour.
Yeah. You gotta get to know them.
So when you got 200 followers, you might think, yeah, man, it's all good, isn't it? Mm-hmm. You don't know the characteristics.
You don't know what's going on behind closed doors. Talk to them. That's why I say episode one, talk to them for long, get to know the character.
And ladies, if you've been single for way too long, and you ain't finding the right man, there must be something that needs to be changed up. There's something going on.
But that could be something wrong with the man them that needs to be changed up.
Because
she could have been single for long because...
Man them are breaking her heart.
Bag of man are, on some bullshit.
Because a lot of... Man them are on bullshit, you know. Man them are on some bullshit. Real bullshit.
So we have to also pay mind to... the certain girls that might try to say, I'm moving like this because you man did this to me. And you, man, treated me a certain way.
That's a whole next topic, not, you know. Yeah,
that's a whole
but we can
one,
get, we want to touch it? See,
no, no.
We'll leave because man,
I just
listen,
put that out there.
No, but, why are we on the subject? Why the Moe is pouring?
Why the Moe is pouring?
Nah, because you know what, it's true. Man, I'm a fucking girl head out here, you know.
No, 100.
Yeah, like, it's mad, you know.
100.
It's mad. Purposely. Because you know what, they know they're not serious from the jump. You know one thing about me now, like, bro, I'm just on the thing that this is where it is. This is, you're chatting to me and we're gonna do something or whatever. I'm telling you, this is where I'm at. So if you choose to fuck with me now,
100%,
you know you're fucking with me 100%. Because you know exactly this is what he's on. So not later down the line, 3 months down the line, you're like, why won't he commit? Well, you knew from the start, man wasn't on the committing thing. 100%. Or you knew from the start, man's out here trapping, trying to get this, you know, secure the bag. You get what I'm saying?
I think I'll say in their defense, in the women's defense.
But it's man them too, it's you know. Some them, man them catch feelings too. Don't get it twisted. Because there's some boss bitches out there that'll be on like, you know what, I'm trying to get paid. And man them are like, oh. Man are all at the, man are all at the letterbox peeking through it like.
I don't know none of them.
Yeah.
And if I do, they don't expose themselves like that. But I'll say women catch feelings.
Yeah.
Yeah, 100%. But no, but I get, but what I'm saying is, what Doug's saying is that when he's kicking it in a situation, he's keeping it real. I'm saying, and what he's saying is, man, them ain't doing it. Man, them are talking a bag of lies.
Bag of shit.
I was talking to one of my good friends today and she was saying to me about man that she's known for a bag of years. She went out at him and the next minute he's bare lies. One before, bare lies.
Bare lies, yeah.
But what it is, and I don't want to expose the man them, but what it is with certain men, I'll just give you girl, this tip alone. Just know that these men, to get the end product of what they want, they're going to tell you anything you want to hear. If you say, I want to be loved and hugged every night 6 times, the man will say, but I love and I want to hug 6 times as well.
Yeah.
You know them ones.
Yeah. But then this is where the man them are fucking up, because you know what I've learned? Sometimes, man are saying what they feel they need to hear to get what they want, but I feel like if you just keep it 100 and say it is for what it is, you give her the opportunity to make the choice. Because 100 times out of 10.
But Doug, that's for the man them that actually have a kid. These men just want a nut.
Yeah.
Man them are saying whatever for the nut. That's what I was trying to say without saying it.
Yeah, man, just
whatever for the nut.
Yeah.
Once they nut.
And there's a lot of that going on.
Come on, man just want a nut. But the gal them are getting drawn into it. Like, I say this.
But sometimes I feel some of the gal want to. They love the chase, they love the game, they love the
thing.
But it goes back
to what we were saying as well, with dating the romance.
Yeah.
True, they're hunting the wrong kind of thing at times.
Yeah.
It's getting messed up.
But is that also part of the Tinder society as well, where it's all this swipe right?
Too much swipe.
If you swipe right and you swipe 15 man, that's 15 conversations, that's 15 different people that you're willing to think that, oh, I fancy him. Then you get what I'm saying? That's 15 different man you might have slept and your body count's gone.
So you...
It's facts. But it works both ways. For man them as well. Man's body can't tie, innit? You get me? If he swipe rats for 15 teams and he's beating 15 teams, listen, he's can't tie.
I was trying to save that for another episode, yeah. When you said there. On the real, I was.
Yeah. But we could talk about that.
We might as well just cut it through now.
Yeah?
But we're saying these girls are trash. And sometimes, like, what you just said there about the body count, I'll make the man them take some accountability on this. We're fucked up, man them are. Because I know some girl that might get labeled a certain way, and really, they shouldn't even. It's just where things have gone left. Because you can get a girl, yeah, that's a decent girl, and she's good. Then she bucks a man. Yeah. The man says, baby, you look so good. I'm going to look after you. Rare. Sees him for a while. She gives it up to him. He's bullshitting. He bounces. Mm. 6 months later, 3 months later, she meets the next man. Right, is that what that brother did to you? Baby, I'm going to take care of you.
Mm.
That ain't going to happen again.
Mm.
Come with me. I'm going to treat you nice.
Man, different.
Grinds her again. He bounces. Mm. He was chatting shit. Now she's got two bodies in her that she... Accidental bodies. You know them ones.
Yeah.
But it's not done there. It continues. Yeah. And so the man continues. Because bare man are on some bullshit. Then the next one wants to beat you up. Then it's three, then four. Now man, them are calling her a hoe. Now she fucked my man.
Yeah.
But all she really wanted was to be loved by one Donnie.
You see what I'm saying to you?
All she wanted was one brother to just treat her good.
Yeah, treat her right.
But now it's all fucked up and she's got a big body count.
Yeah.
That shit happens. Am I lying?
You can't even say that. Like, the girl, she's learned from her mistakes, isn't it?
Listen. Carry on, go on.
Masculine shit.
Go on.
She's got to learn from her mistakes, man. Do you get me?
I know what you're saying, but it's not a mistake because you know what? Some women just want to be loved, bro. Certain women just want to be loved, and certain men are really fuckery for twanging up the girl's head and giving her all the sweet nothings. That's why I say you have to keep it 100. If you're not on the, like, you see, like, if these, like you say, from the second body count, let's say from the second one, the brother was like, look, I like you, let's do this thing, but man's not on this.
Then she knows what
Then she can actually say, you know what, actually, call it a day. But you know what it is? Sometimes everyone feels like everything they meet, they got a fuck. And it's not that. Sometimes you could tell a girl the realness, and she's like, you know what, episode one. Like, if she says, oh, you know what, you're cool, like, but nah, well, that's a brethren then. It's good to have female friends.
Every girl around here, a man needs to understand that as well. Man, them are hunters by nature. Some of these men are hunting dirty where, like I said, I love females, bro. So I've got a bag of beautiful cousins, bro. So I know they're out there in this world. So that's why I've got to say certain things to make it be known. Because I don't want men to come and... I've had situations where one of my cousins has got fooled up and a man's come and talked a bag of shit.
Yeah, of course.
I know my cousin directly is a goodest. But she's fell for the bullshit.
And
man's took advantage of the situation.
Because I know, I've got female cousins.
They don't want to tell man because they know man will come and just... I didn't know.
Man will be like, what happened? You know, like at them family dinners when you find out when she air chatting to your other cousin and all of a sudden...
No one don't want to tell man.
You say, what was that?
Exactly, but that's what I'm saying. So when I'm saying it, you can't really put it down to they should learn from their mistakes because they just got drawn in. Them are hustlers. Man them perfect their craft. You know them way of scamming. You know, we're growing up in an environment, a lot of men are, not all, where we're tricking our way through certain things.
Yeah.
But now man them are bringing that to the females and we've lost the element of wanting to look after females.
Yeah.
I'm old school in my mentality. Older than my aging mentality.
When you say look after, break it down. Like,
I'm talking where in my mindset is when I'm with my woman or a woman, and when I'm with a woman, if I'm with her, I feel a level of responsibility to kind of, you know, I'm going to take care of you. Whatever levels it is,
you're
with me. So as such, I'm not going to dish you. There's times back in the day where I was with a girl for all of 2 years just because the way I brucked up her ex-man, if I didn't stay with her, no, on some real shit. If I didn't stay with her, his sisters and all them things.
You felt like you would have left her to see.
Can I just say, he called it on.
Mm-hmm.
Them whipped man.
Yeah.
Them whipped man.
Yeah.
But he called it on. Situation occurred. Man stamped out the situation.
Literally.
But because she was there, literally, because she was there.
Masculine shit.
In front of her, you know them way there.
Let her know what it is. Look at her while man stamping.
The joke of it is. You're making me flashback. I think I said that.
Yeah.
I was like, look at her. This is what it's over yet. While I'm holding the But anyway, too much.
Someone said to me the other day as well. They was like, oh, whenever Pals goes to talk about his history, he never wants to get too much. He always says it's too much.
Anyway. Where was I now? I lost it now because we've got to cover that. We've got to make sure everything's by the book.
Everything's
by the book. So yeah, I'm saying that scenario. I've stayed with her because of that. Because after that now, sisters want to brock her up. Cousins want
to
brock her up.
You feel like you have to protect.
So I'm just like, you're going to stay with me now.
Yeah.
I'm not even feeling you that much. But I'm going to stay. It's a responsibility. I put you in this situation, you know? So I'm not just going to leave you out there like that. You end up staying... And so that nothing goes on. But I think that's where men have lost that kind of looking after females kind of way. And, you know, like how your granddad would have looked after your grandma.
Yeah.
You know them ones?
Yeah.
And them kind of way.
But you know what I feel like as well? Like what you just said, that's realness. I feel like a lot of people, there's a lot of fake behavior. Like if you're a real man and you keep it 100, like, and it was funny because I was saying to, I was chatting to someone the other day and I was chatting about America. And how they are in Atlanta and how they are in America, where like these girls, like certain of these American women will know that if they're with a certain type of guy, like he might do certain type of things, but they're riding it out with man because he's real about it and it is what it is. And I feel like in the UK, we've got real brothers, but I feel like there's a lot of lying or not telling the truth.
And I
feel like, you see like what you're saying there, where you was like, rah, nah, you're with me, keeping it 100, this is what it is. You get what I'm
saying? Keep it 100. Like you just said it yourself. You said you tell them, this is how it is. I'm with you. We're just seeing each other, whatever. You're just kicking the rule. And then if it goes that way, it goes. If it don't, it don't. These men are feeding these girls dreams.
Yeah.
And then wondering why they're going mad afterwards because you fed them the, I'm going to do this. We're going to move in. We're going to do that. We're going to do this. Until you nut.
Yeah. If you are, and you know what it is? And you know what is also a fucked up move as well? Like what you're saying, selling them dreams, but not saying nothing. Mm. Just going with the flow. Mm. And I got to lie. I can't lie. I've been guilty in the past when I was younger of being in relationships and just rolling with it.
Mm.
You get what I'm saying? Mm. Not actually even saying what I want and what I want to do, but just going with the flow. Then two's round. Man's in a full-blown relationship he don't even want to be in.
Come on.
Yeah, and that's what happens when that...
These girls are put in a relationship you don't even know about.
But don't even know about. But it's because you just kind of didn't say nothing and you just rolled with the punches. Do you get what I'm saying? And that's why now I've learned. Now as I've got older, I'm like, nah. When I'm saying this is what I want, this is what I want. And if you're not fucking with that, then it's cool. Do you get what I'm saying? We can be friends and we can just hold it down. But at least you know where I'm coming at and what I'm on.
Straight.
You know what I'm saying?
Nah, it's real. So we're saying... What was the thing my man said again? What's the whole quote? This generation of women are differently trash.
We're putting some reason and logic in it at the same 100%. Time.
We're not just throwing it out there.
Nah.
And like I said, there's
because some women will hear the topic and feel like, rah, I'm not trash.
But there's also good women out there. No, those that see the topic and think, man, say good. That's wonderful.
Yeah.
If you see it and you think you're not trash and you know you're not trash, hold your hand them up in the air, wave them like you just don't care.
Yeah.
We salute you. You know them ones.
Drink to that.
We love that. Drink to that. Salute to all of you, to the good as them.
To the good as. Salute, dance.
Drink to that.
Mm-hmm. Know your thing set.
Come on, because it's not everyone's trash. There's a gal out there laughing at this same boy. They know they got food on flame.
But you
utes,
know what's
yards tidy, utes looked after.
But you know what's the man? Certain gal will watch this and be like, you know what? Fuck them niggas there, tear, start bracking. You know what I'm saying? That's how this society is fucked. You know what I'm saying?
Most definitely. That's up to them. That's up to them. But there's a good as out there, like I just said, that know everything's as it should be. They're loyal to a man when they're with it.
Yeah.
The yards tidy, food in the fridge. Ute them's nice and tidy, looked after. They do their own thing. Get on with what they need to get on with and do what they need to do. You understand? Boy. So salute to them.
Salute.
But as to the trash, we got to call it what it is. This is Winners Talk and we say it straight.
Straight
trash.
So
trashy. If we see some trash business going on, we just got to call it out.
Yeah.
Simple as that.
We don't support the trash out here, man.
No, we're not with the trash. We're not with the, you're looking all fresh and head to toe in all a designer thing. And then your utes walking with you, no snotty, ruffle up clothes. From wherever he's not dressed too nice.
Yeah.
You know, let's have the youth dress nice.
You start taking and pride
you looking
in that
and you looking a bit normal, or even better than that, louder designer thing if you can't afford it, and you and your youth both dress nice and humble and some moderates clothes because next and all them shop got some nice little garms and you can still look nice.
Yeah,
and do up your yard because there's no point going out there and you're looking all glamour, but your yard looking
mad. Man, come to your yard and the doors all hanging off and all this shit.
Yeah, that's a mad yard. This
that's a mad yard. That's about like a tea house. That's about like a tea house. You know, like that. Yeah,
that shit happens, blood. I remember them days. Girl, you had all the no carpet and them days carpet. There, you know, no carpet and the. I remember them days, black.
Yeah.
Come on,
man, for step lightly, car. You're not even trying to get a splinter in your foot. Come on, there's no.
Yeah, come on, bro, some mad ones going on, blood, going in some skip, yards skip. And
Wild. Man's so, looking at his clock. Where, man, I might have a cut out of here soon.
Yeah, come on.
You weren't looking like this in the rave. Sold man the dream.
Yeah, he sold man the dream.
Hey, bruh.
All right, let's get current. Let's get current for a moment.
Come then.
Let's talk on some. I tell you what, I've been watching a lot of this week or the last couple of weeks. I've been watching a lot of the. There's been a lot of documentaries coming out.
Yeah.
So I see the Graham Daly one.
Oh, shit. Yeah, yeah.
That looked good.
Yeah.
Big up to them on the come up. I like that because it breaks down the whole come up of how they went
there's
about.
There's been quite a few still.
That was good. I like that. The CBiz one was dope. I like the CBiz one. Have you seen it?
No, I didn't watch it.
Yeah, you should check that out. He goes back to his... That was proper, innit? You see that? That was hard. That was a solid documentary as well. Salute. Yeah, salute to Biz. Salute to... It was Link Up that did it. Yeah, Link Up TV. That was a proper thing.
I swear Link Up put out one as well. I see something on the gram today chatting about...
That's the Graham Daly one, I think.
But, is that the Graham Daly one?
They all kind of linked up in one.
Is they all in one? Okay,
yeah,
I need
you
to
probably
watch them.
Saw it Made You Think or something.
Yeah. I see it on Made You Think. Yeah.
That was hard. The documentary thing's working. I like that. Got to promote the thing. Got to show our stories and all of that. So that's tough. If you ain't seen them, check them out.
That's
good. That's a good look. I know there's a Channel U one coming as well.
And I swear Channel U's coming back anyway, isn't it?
I don't know if he's coming back full time or if he's just coming back for that day to show something, but hope it does come back.
I think the culture needs that.
The culture needs it, yes. That's the original foundation. It did wonders for me, I'm not going to lie.
Yeah, no, originators. Man grew up on Channel U still.
Picked
them up. You get me?
What else has been going on current?
I don't know. You know what? Since you started talking about podcasts and that, I start paying attention to certain things that are going on. So I see something with ZZ Mills and the next you arguing. Look wild. That was a bit mad.
Yeah. What was that? That was, I was talking about in the car. That's No Behaviour. Yeah. Shout out to them. Good shout podcast them. Again.
Yeah, good
I
team.
Think it was, yeah, that's Margs' podcast, isn't it? Yeah, yeah, shout out to them. That was, them man was, I see, he was arguing hard with ZZ Mills.
Right, he's going a little too hard.
What was he saying? Too hard? What was he going
to do? I don't know. I just caught, like, you know me, I'm like, look, until we started doing this thing, I didn't pay attention to podcasts, innit? You get what I'm saying? I didn't even know what a podcast, like, I knew what they were, but I weren't watching nothing, yeah? So now I'm all of a sudden, when I see something on social media, I'm like, right, what's this? Let me see what they're saying. But listen, you can't be out here arguing with a guy like that, man. Man, I don't even know. Like, I'm just talking from my own personal point of view. I don't really care.
Just cool.
Yeah, just talking reason. You get what I'm saying?
Yeah, man, shouting too much.
Shouting way too much. Like, come on, man. Even if we got a disagreement and it's a female, even if it's man, them, I'm just gonna state my just like, what are you doing? Where are you gonna hot her up? You know what I'm saying?
I only watched the first second.
No, but she held it down.
No, she held it down.
Yeah. Don't get twisted. Yeah. She weren't chatting. No, she weren't
see
like.
With her, she's smart and she's not soft. Yeah. You know them ones, so she can kind of.
I kind of rate her. Yeah, still.
I rate her thing. You know what? Yeah. I rate her thing as well. She folds who she can fold.
Yeah.
And she gives homage and respect to who she knows.
Yeah.
Masculine shit.
Masculine rules.
The energy that I saw her try bring to certain man. I won't even say them to embarrass them because I've seen a chief up man
and deal with man
a certain way.
I see the odd things on
where
the
she kind of having up man.
Yeah.
And then I see her chatting to my boy, chatting to Big Nasty. Shout out Big Nasty.
And treating man with the...
Like she sat across Big Nasty. She looked like a little girl just listening with her arms just crossed, listening. As a big man kick facts to her.
Yeah.
Masculine
and
shit.
And I think people you know need to understand as well with Nasty, been around a long time.
Like, let me show you something about Nasty. Nasty's been around a long time. And he's on his job and he's a good dude.
He's not stupid.
He's a good dude. When me and him link up, it's always love. He give me joke. He's humble with it.
Yeah,
his little brother fights for my team.
Is it?
So when we link up and all of that, it's always love and always respect. And he's a good guy, blood. When he opened his gym, he rang me and was like breaking it down, asking him about certain things. Because obviously I've done it before.
Good dude.
But yeah, when he was chatting to ZZ Mills, she was humble with it, bro. Because she was respecting what's going on.
And
it comes back to what we say. Like, if you're official, women will naturally show a level of respect for you. Because you're masculine official. Whether they realise it or not. She might not realise that her whole demeanour was different when she was talking to Big Nasty, how she's talking to next man.
I respect that from her
because you've got to show her something to respect.
Yeah.
And then when you show her something to respect, then it's like,
They conduct themselves different, man. But then, watching what I watched, bruh, there was no level of respect. Yeah. But then, because there was no level of respect, man took it an octave higher. That was really unnecessary. We don't need to go there. I don't care. I don't even know who the brother is. So I don't even know. But at the same time, that's not how we're dealing with it.
No.
So like, bro, I can't.
You can't. What it is, you must. For me personally, I know to control my thoughts, my emotions on certain things. So you ain't gonna draw me out like that.
Yeah. No way. No way. Will you see man plays cards.
Also,
you get me
in that environment. I guess if she's been invited to your show.
Look after her, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, and kind of just 100. Reason and pat. Yeah. Basically,
it's levels.
Levels, because she's doing her thing, and if she's come, just you know, everyone just cool. And if something offends you a certain way, you got to be able to deal with it. It's life, though. But everyone's different.
I think my man was trying to embarrass her.
I'll be honest, I only saw what I saw on Made You Think. Yeah, I think it was either Made You Think or one of them. I didn't watch the whole thing. But there was a snippet thing, but there was like a few snippets. So it wasn't just like a minute.
Okay, man caught like
a good couple, a good couple 5 minutes of arguing, But I didn't get what it was over, but regardless of whatever it's over, you're on a podcast, it can't be that deep. It's not like you're talking over some PCOG or something like that. It's not that deep. It's over a disagreement over something that's been said. So therefore, it don't warrant. Even for me, like, if it was in that, I'd be like, all right, cool, say what you're saying. When the cameras are off now, I'd be like, listen, boom, I didn't feel what you were saying, but it is what it is.
Mm.
But For man to raise it up to some level, then talk about, ah, you're single, you ain't got this, you're single.
Oh, is that where it went?
Yeah, it went some next, it went waywards. Come on. I don't know if anyone see it, it went waywards. But I'm only watching snippets, you know me, P. I don't really. Come on,
I'm just saying, I see my podcast, or Made You Think.
Yeah, sick.
That 3 minutes. I just saw. So that means I've seen, well, I'm saying I've seen a podcast, but I've only seen 3 minutes.
Yeah.
You ain't going to post up the whole thing.
Yeah.
I don't really sit and watch a whole episode.
Yes, to get the whole.
I'm just catching up. You saying I should? Listen, but hold on. When I was about to start this thing, I said to my cousin, I said, Daps, what, should I watch some podcasts before I do it? He said, nah, don't watch none of them. Go and do your own thing.
I'm saying go do your own thing. If a man's making music, go make your music.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's partly why I don't watch them.
But when I'm saying, right, watch the whole thing, you see where you get a little clip of Donald Trump or something?
Yeah, saying
a mad thing. And then you say, nah.
Yeah, but I'm wild. You see me?
But nah, but this one sounds like he saw enough to know what's going on.
I saw enough to know that. But you see, even like, watch them. Bro, my tolerance and my interest level, bro, if you don't, like, I can't sit there and watch an hour of something.
I hear you.
If it's not going to captivate me within the first five minutes of me watching it.
I hear you.
Because time is precious. Do you get what I'm saying?
You believe it and you can't get an hour
back. Yeah, plus I'm mad like that. Like, I'm just like, I don't know.
I'm the same. No, I fully hear you. Yeah. I fully hear you, Douglas.
Like, you see, like, when certain people are talking, I can listen to it. And when certain people are talking, I can't. Simple, you know what I'm saying?
No, simple, talk the things.
So some people, like, since like you show me certain things, I tap in, I watch it, and I say, okay, that's cool. Mm. So like even now, when I do see these clips, normally I scroll past them. But when I saw that today, I said, right, let me, you know what I'm saying? It's not even like we plan to even talk about it, but I just see it today, and I was like, right, that's wild.
Some of them are worth taking.
I haven't watched. I know about them ones there because when I ask or when I hear people, those are the names that people mentioned to me. My brother said to me, he said to me, Margs, he said to me from before, he said, Margs is one with the, I don't know the other guy's name.
I
can't remember. Yeah. But yeah, going back to the original topic, we're calling certain people trash. So if we're going to call certain people trash, certain women trash, we as men have got to carry it right as well.
Yeah.
And that's why we're not shy. I'm not shying away from it. Like, we went hard at certain men and the man and the behavior in the episode
and
one.
And we know that we'll mostly go hard on them again.
Exactly. So the women have to get.
Because man, them be fuckery, fam. So they have to get highlighted. You get me? But long, the gal them need long. To also understand they do fuckery as well. And it's always the man's fault.
So yeah, it's not always the man's fault. We're going to balance it out, you know?
Yeah.
We're going to talk it how it is. And that's the energy we're bringing to the table. So yeah, as far as the all women are. No, not all women. As far as
the comments will be mad.
Nah, as far as the, I keep wanting to say exactly how my bridge said it to me. You know what I mean? I don't want to misquote, man. Because when he looked up at me at the table, the emotion was real. You know them ones.
And that man, yeah.
He didn't finish it. He didn't even start his food. Half a chicken.
Hot
peri-peri chips and garlic bread. Blood, I saw the whole plate get left.
Yeah.
As he said, women this generation are differently trash.
Differently trash. And listen, also people interact with us, man. Let us know, like, in the comments, like, if you're feeling what's being said or you got something to say on it, we will touch on it. We'll read it, touch it, come back on it. Roll back on that. You get me? Like, if you disagree or agree.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? We're open. We want to hear it. Drop in the comments. Say, we like this. We don't like that. We think you're wrong on this. We think you're right on that. And I say again, no one here is saying that it's all. We're more than aware. There's some great, great, great women going on out there.
Some fabulous women out there.
Fabulous,
man.
Like you just said. Listen, God bless them.
Listen, all you women out there doing your thing, man. I fully rate it.
Come on, don't get it twisted. But them women, they know there's some other women out there that's trash.
Yeah, yeah, of course. Because it's funny enough, because even when man mentioned something earlier and I was on the phone, like the first thing my girl said was like, yeah, there's a lot of trashy girls. Like, yeah, perfect. Bare trashy girls out there. So they know. She was the first one to say, Gala, where there's trashy girls out there.
Come on.
You get me?
We're near the end. Yeah. I've got to just say this one little story. Near the end. Because I've just read it. Because you just made me remember. There's this girl scene. Nice looking thing. Premium. You know them ones? Premium, you know?
Well, we're talking elite.
The gal look good.
Mm-hmm.
Man kind of, you know, back in the, man would mentor her a little piece.
Yeah.
You know them way, the schooler trying to show a certain thing. I used to say to her, listen.
Yeah.
You're a Nike chick right now, but you could be a Chanel chick if you just finesse some little bits and pieces.
Mm-hmm.
She's on the thing of, yeah, yeah, definitely, but she can't help how she is. Money, 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 money. You know them ones?
Yeah, yeah.
But I'm saying to her, like, listen, that will come. But yeah. you gotta move right. You gotta be official.
Yeah.
I'm not effing with her. This is just a.
Oh, so you're just coaching?
Not effing with her. I'm just coaching. Purely coaching. I'm not effing with her.
Let's be clear on that. Yeah.
It's just that. Like I said, people need to understand that. Yeah, some people's got to learn to understand
that. Yeah, people got to understand that. Yeah, you got to be able to.
She used to mash little works for man here and there.
Because when they bust you, they look up.
Man, she used to mash some works for man here and there. Like, man would help her make some money here and there on certain little things. But anyway. Before she got to that stage where she was doing bits for man, she must have come to man with one argument on some, I just need to make some money. I was like, yeah, I hear that. So what's the... She goes, there's one new zebra crossing that's been put up on my ends. And it weren't there before. It's only been there all of like 2 weeks. And because cars ain't used to it, they're coming around the corner a bit too fast. I'm like, okay.
Mm-hmm.
She's like, so I'm saying... When the time comes, I'm going to time it. I'm just going to step out and get licked down. Because they're kind of breaking anyway when they see it. She goes, but it's too late. And she goes, you know, I just get licked down. I must can get a 20 racks.
Wow. I'm done.
I was done from then. I said, hold on a minute.
I'm done.
I said to her, are you stupid? She's like, what? I was like, so what? Okay, yeah, go for it. She's like, what? I said, well, yeah, for when the man misjudges it and he licks you down and you're dead, or he licks you down and you lose your leg, or you lose your arm, you idiot. I said, what are you talking about? She's like, oh, I didn't think like that. You know, I just thought it's a man. It's like, you lot need, go and look a job, you fool.
Yeah.
You know
them
ones? Go look
man
a little
job.
Man done
all this mentoring for you to come with that.
Lad, this was before them. This was before the mentoring.
This was before.
Let's be clear. If I was mentoring at that stage, she'd have had to get kicked off the program. You know them ones. She's not on the YTS no more. If I'm mentoring and you say that, you're off the YTS and you're not on the scheme no more.
Not on the scheme.
You know them.
You're moving wild.
You're moving wild.
You're a liability now.
You're a liability now.
Yeah.
That's why I had to start mentoring, because I was like, you're moving crazy.
Yeah.
And as a young girl, see, this is the thing as well. As a young girl, she's got a young you as well,
yeah,
that she's trying to bring up and make money and this, that, the other. And in a way, I kind of felt for her because the utes, she's young, the utes young, she ain't young. Like, say at the time she was 26 and her ute was, say, I don't know, 8, you know, them ones, and she's just trying to fucking get true. You understand what I'm saying? So I feel for sometimes for these little chicks like that. So when I'm hearing them foolishness about you're going to get licked down at the lights, I'm just saying to her, nah, there's better ways.
Better ways.
Gave her a job at one of my spots, let her work for a while, start getting some regular income and showed her the better way. And big up to her still, because right now she's on point.
Yeah.
She's on point, Doug.
To the point where
she's like, yeah, I've got a such and such a money park off at this house. I've got such and such a money park off that man. And she always be like, I appreciate you so much, Rurik. She's on point.
Yeah.
And the level of how she was looking good then has just increased.
She's
on point. Yeah. But she needed that guidance. And sometimes that can be where these girls go wrong. You could buck up on the wrong man or not have no mentor.
Yeah.
You understand? Mm. Because I love
you. That's a whole deep next topic.
But I ain't really met many women that don't at times need a little guidance.
Yeah.
You lot are strong, I understand. But you are still the weaker and fairer sex. Sometimes you need that guidance, but you can come up on the wrong mentor that puts his hands on or goes on with some fuck you or shows you completely the wrong way instead of the right way.
You know what Pusha T said it in that tune, he's got a tune where he said,
I never met a hoe that didn't need a little guidance. Come on,
man. Yeah.
Come on.
I'm masculine shit. I knew the line, you know. He knew the line.
Come on, because I'm slack. That shit's real. Certain things touch my soul. Real spit.
I always felt that bar, you know.
Real spit.
Real spit. Like, come on, man. And women, don't get it twisted, like, obviously. But we know how the thing's set, innit. Like, if you've got a masculine man, like, obviously, he's gonna lead the way. Like no woman's leading me the way. You get what I'm saying? I'm gonna lead the way.
But that's what it is. And they will trust it if you show them that you're certain. All women want is for you to show them
you're
certain enough for you to take control of the steering wheel and show them the way. And you show me, babes, and now you can run.
But that's
you've got to earn that.
But I feel this is another topic.
We've got a lot of topics. We've got to write these down.
I feel like this is something that we need to get into still. But you know what? Time is of the essence. But that's a sick one. Because, bruh, not a lot. Listen, not a lot of men are showing gal the way. Like, there's
that's
a lot
the next
of,
topic. Don't
yeah,
even say no more.
Yeah, don't even say,
don't even say no more.
More
on it.
Listen,
don't even say no more on it. We're going to spin back on that. Yeah, we're going to keep going. We're going to keep going.
Yeah,
but we're going to spin back on that. Because there is not a lot of men showing gal the way. And that's important.
Yeah.
You must show gal the way.
Yeah.
It's a role. Because you wouldn't want your cousin to get treated like shit. Are you going to do the things to, are you going to want your cousin to go through the things that you're putting certain gal through?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And not even like sexually, like even
I'm just talking in general.
General.
I don't even mean sexual.
Yeah, yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
are you going to want your sister? Are you going to want your daughter?
Yeah.
You understand? To grow up and go through certain things. So you got to kind of be aware there's a level of responsibility.
Mm-hmm.
A certain level of responsibility. You understand?
Masculine shit.
Masculine shit.
Man, say it. And man, I need to understand we're living that shit.
Yeah,
bro.
Yeah. So I'm not just talking it for the sake of talking it. I'm not saying I'm perfect.
Nah.
But I know my role and I know what I'm supposed to do. So you hear me say little things and I'm saying it freely. It's not like I'm having to think about it when I say, I think I'm mentoring and it's just facts only because that's my outlook because there's a level of responsibility. Same way I'll be mentoring certain man and this, that, other. I've got man that I'm mentoring and there's fighters and this, that, the other and youths. It's the same way with the females. There's a level of, what, we just leaving them out?
Yeah.
What are we doing?
Yeah. Plus, also, when you're saying mentoring, it's real because people think mentoring, like, and think of the, no, like, when you're actually there giving someone information, trying to push their life forward on a day-to-day basis when they call your phone and do whatever you're doing, that's mentoring.
Of course it is.
Like, you get what I'm saying? It's motivational. It's mentoring. You're trying to guide people to the light, like, what you're trying to do. Do you get what I'm saying? And that's some real shit.
Listen, I've got greater ones there where I could say, but I don't want to expose their personal business where I know I've played a role in their life to a point where they've done well and they've said to me, "Rah, I couldn't have done this without you and this, that, the other, and you've been such a help and blah." Because that's if you reach the top, there's a level of responsibility to send the elevator back down to come get some people.
Yeah,
you understand?
Yeah.
That's how we're moving. So if we're gonna call certain females trash, let's make sure that we've done everything that we could do in the meantime to try and help
and save them
and help. There you go, and help bring them into a better position and all of that kind of stuff.
About,
you understand?
Yeah.
So, with that said, I think we've covered it all.
Trashy women can become winners too.
Yes. Hear the words of Big Doug. Trashy women can become winners too, you know. It's a
mindset, winners talking.
But don't oversell the product because no one's going to want it after it's been... Oh, you know what I mean?
Trashy.
You ain't going to buy a car. You're going to want to know how many owners on the vehicle. If you're buying a secondhand motor, you're going to want to know how many... Me personally, I'm a man. If I see more than, one, two owners, I ain't really want that car, you know?
If it's a Cat D or salvage. You know, if it's Cat D or salvage,
you understand,
but...
man said Cat D or salvage, you know? On that note, I think that's where we're going to have to end this. Love to the real ones. The not so real ones, and I think
trust me,
up the levels a little piece.
Yeah, man.
Back again.